We are building a whole new dimension of the global energy system. It's like nothing we've ever done before. Imagine you could bottle your sunshine. You could bottle your wind energy and ship it all around the world. That's effectively the promise of hydrogen.
Green hydrogen can specifically play an important role in decarbonizing a heavy industry.
And there is a clear pathway to scale hydrogen globally.
We see hydrogen as a key contributor and enabler of the global energy transition.
Beyond the breakthrough, beyond just the innovation, actually make these projects real in the world.
The green hydrogen strategy is really crucial to unlocking this mega potential for integration and economic development regionally.
The way we see it, that clean hydrogen is not a myth or a mirage, that clean hydrogen can be real, it just takes hard work.
Renewable energy is powering more of our world than ever before, but electricity can't solve everything, and that's where hydrogen comes in.
There are parts of the economy that cannot be electrified, that simply cannot run on electrons. We are talking about heavy industries, steel, cement, we are talking about shipping, we are talking about effectively anything with long range, high degree temperature, or things that are heavy. And that's where hydrogen can help.
Hydrogen is an energy input molecule, helps decarbonize those industries. That includes things like ammonia production for fertilizer, the creation of other fuels such as sustainable aviation fuels and fuels for shipping. And that's what we aim at as a hydrogen producer, is we want to decarbonize those industries that otherwise can't.
But here's the catch. Most of the hydrogen we produce today is made using fossil fuels.
Today, most hydrogen is produced using fossil fuels. That means on a life cycle basis, there are emissions. Now, importantly, when hydrogen is used, there are no emissions. So really what matters is how we create that hydrogen, how we deploy it, and how we then take stock of its emissions from the beginning to the end. So what we're really after here is cleaning that process up and making sure that it is as low or zero emission as can be throughout the whole life cycle, throughout the whole process. That is the difference between clean hydrogen and the conventional kind of hydrogen that's been used for decades. And then we can be sure that we have a real climate solution here.
Removing fossil fuels from hydrogen production creates a new challenge. Making clean hydrogen requires lots of renewable energy. So where better to kickstart the clean hydrogen revolution than areas abundant in natural energy sources? Could innovations here be key to clean hydrogen at scale?
So one of the reasons why Namibia is so well positioned to produce green hydrogen is because of its incredible wind and solar resources. Clean hydrogen is essentially hydrogen that is produced through the process of electrolysis, so where we use water to extract the hydrogen and it's powered by renewable energies.
And what is so distinctly different from how the oil and gas and the mining industry have worked is that you cannot export the wind or the sun. It has to be developed in country. And it is renewable in nature. We're looking at producing millions of tons of green hydrogen annually that is produced with Namibian labor, using as far as we can Namibian materials, equipment, services, etc., etc. So countries in the global south, like Namibia, can now become the alternative supply sources for countries in the global north. And those countries, incidentally, do not have those resources to do it domestically. And so the geopolitical landscape and the geoeconomic landscape is shifting.
The Hyphen Hydrogen Project is a gigawatt scale, fully integrated green hydrogen project. It's located in the southwesterly part of Namibia. We look to fully implement it by 2030 from roughly 7 gigawatt of a combination of wind and solar and about 3 gigawatt of electrolyzer capacity. We can see that the role of Hyphen as a catalyst to this industry is immense.
While clean hydrogen demand is growing, its use in heavy industry and long-distance transport is still less than 0.1% of global demand.
So how does clean hydrogen scale globally? We think about the markets for clean hydrogen in a couple of different phases. To support the initial production of clean hydrogen, I think the path to market is going to be primarily through converting hydrogen into energy carriers, whether that be in the form of ammonia, methanol, or other energy carrier, in part because they're easier to store and transport. You're seeing countries like Singapore lead the way in the bunkering of that fuel. You're seeing maritime vessel manufacturers now producing ships fired and driven by a clean hydrogen fuel. Eventually, I think as an industry, we're gonna see the adoption of more pure hydrogen infrastructure. And it's not as if hydrogen infrastructure does not exist today. There are existing hydrogen pipelines and hydrogen storage techniques that are implemented in commercial today. Those are sort of the green shoots of infrastructure that we think create the next wave of demand for clean hydrogen molecules.
As the global clean hydrogen network is being built, are there other steps that can speed up its growth?
So the pathway to clean hydrogen scaling globally is very simple, at least in theory. We need three things. One is clear and stable regulation, so that businesses know how to make investment decisions. We need global standards. That is absolutely key, so we can compare apples and apples and oranges with oranges when it comes to hydrogen, its cleanliness, its environmental attributes, and so on and so forth. And lastly, we need visibility on offtake. It's not enough to produce the hydrogen. We need to deploy it somewhere where it makes sense. And for that, we need help in terms of matching production and offtake. So it really does require a whole new way of thinking and a whole new way of working together.
Some of the key roadblocks for bringing clean hydrogen to market are finding the matches between supply and demand. According to the IEA, the industry needs to produce 100 million tons of decarbonized hydrogen by 2050. We need buyers to step up to long-term structured contracts. We need partners who are in it for the long term, who are committed to providing both the necessary equipment, providing the necessary financing. This is how we get beyond the breakthrough, beyond just the innovation, actually make these projects real in the world.
Breaking through challenges in clean hydrogen is helping rethink global energy and kickstart new opportunities.
Namibia has developed a green hydrogen industrialization strategy and roadmap that will be implemented throughout Southern Africa. And what that shared green hydrogen infrastructure will be able to do is unlock new synergies between these countries. What is envisaged as part of that infrastructure is the development of what is called a green hydrogen backbone. So basically a pipeline that flows from Namibia into South Africa, where Namibia can supply to South Africa green hydrogen for its heavy industries. We're looking at about a $10 billion investment, which is roughly the equivalent of the Namibian GDP. So you can see through that Namibia has the potential to become a significant producer of green hydrogen and therefore help the world in reaching its objectives of decarbonization.
Turning that potential into reality will take more than ambition. It will require significant financial effort. Is the size of the opportunity big enough to deliver for the environment and convince investors to overcome the financial hurdles ahead?
We estimate that it would take about $680 billion to get us on track for net zero here. So the investment need is considerable. Whenever I talk about investment numbers in hydrogen, I get big eyes. Those seem like massive amounts of money. But the reality is that they are just drops in the ocean compared to what we spend on energy today. In 2020, we started with about $10 billion of committed capital. And in 2024, we are at $75 billion, so seven times more in just the last 4 years. and over 400 projects, four times more in terms of projects. So undeniable, hydrogen is happening. Those are real projects, real investments.
At Eight Rivers, we view part of our job is to bring the technologies to fruition that actually provide investors those returns. And that's, you know, that's how we see the world. At the end of the day, energy has to be low cost because that's what creates the most human prosperity.
When scaling up, agreeing on how to measure clean hydrogen is key. So, what should we be measuring? And will it be enough to shift hydrogen to a genuinely clean industry?
Really, what we're talking about here is clean hydrogen. And we need to have absolute clarity on what we mean by that. So how that hydrogen is produced, how the environmental and climate attributes of that hydrogen are defined, how we measure them, how we verify them, how we certify them, and how we bring them to the market. With that clarity, certainty, and trust, we can start trading. We can start moving hydrogen around. We can start importing, exporting, and we can really motivate investors to put money on the table. We can motivate off-takers to make commitments for purchasing over a period of time. That is what will get the hydrogen system going. Look, if we want a sustainable future, we have to act like we want it. Clean hydrogen has a key role to play in the energy transition. It is not a silver bullet. It will not solve all of our problems, but it is a key contributor and enabler.
And I think that's when everyone will see it the way we see it, that clean hydrogen is not a myth or a mirage, that clean hydrogen can be real. It just takes hard work.